five times. First time back in Plovdiv in 2009. Also in Sheffield 2011, Lugano 2012, Zagreb 2013, and Strasbourg 2014. So we have a multiple winner in Carlan up against a young, exciting French fencer in Manon Brunet.
Fight of the day so far, though, is Brunet's. That taking apart of the most in-form women's sabre of the season, Sofia Velikaya, was very, very impressive.
And just if you're watching at home, they haven't changed the scoreboard from the men's foil final. So it's not Daniele Garozzo and Alicia Facconi. We just need to get the names up. We've got Manon Brunet on the right of your screen up against Olga Carlan on the left. So slight delay as we work out the techniques inside the scoreboard. Referee for this final will be Marius Florea of Romania.
Yeah, Jean-Philippe Durrell there looking on. A little edge in Brunet's fencing today. And he looks a little edgy. Down the other end of the piece, Olga Carlan has got Yuri Marchenko in the box, coaching her. Carlan has tons of experience on podium pieces. And she'll have tons of experience of a delay like this, which has now been fixed. The names are correct now.
So here we go. This is the gold medal match. Olga Carlan on the left, Manon Brunet on the right. The women's sabre competition at the European Fencing Championships in Düsseldorf.
First point to Carlan. They look like they're going at each other in the middle to get this one underway. Patience from Brunet, stepping in, trying to draw something from Carlan. Carlan didn't explode straight away. A slow, patient attack. You can bet your bottom dollar that Carlan was watching Brunet and will have come up with a game plan after watching her beat Sofia Velikaya. Picks up the blade there, Brunet, as Carlan steps in, and she's off the mark now.
And Carlan just asking the referee there exactly what happened, and yes, agreeing that Brunet did pick up the blade. If you're new to fencing, this is sabre. It's a cutting weapon. You can score with the length of the blade as well as the point, and the target is everything above the torso. It's a weapon of convention, so the referee has to decide who the attacking fencer is. If you're being attacked, then you can either run away and defeat the attack through distance or parry your opponent's weapon. Your third option is to hit on the counter, but then you really cannot be hit because it will be your opponent's point. If there are two colored lights on the box, one colored light on the box, it's very easy. It's going to go to whoever hits on target. So simultaneous. Both fencers going at each other at the same time. It's used as a tactic. Manon Brunet getting the better of that one. And Olga Carlan calling for a video review. So now, Karim, you've watched the difference in styles of these two fencers. I mean, Olga Carlan, very, very tactically astute.
Yeah, and a great work rate as well. She's got outstanding techniques. So she's got the Holy Trinity, if you like. And it is that tactical decision-making that could be Brunet's outdoing. But she's a deceptively strong athlete. For someone so slight, she's very, very strong. And she's got great focus. And since Rio, the Olympic Games there, her attitude has changed. She wants to fence how she wants to fence. She stopped thinking about her opponents too much.
And she's grown up a bit as well.
Well, there is that. She's still very young.
Olga Carlan going for the long attack. Brunet trying to hit with the out-of-time counter, but Carlan able to finish the attack. And then if you're new to fencing, it doesn't matter who hits first. It matters who has started the attack first. And you can see there, great example of that. Brune comes in, but it's not her turn to attack. Carl unable to finish. Nothing given on that particular occasion. They're going together in the middle. Look at the feet. If you're watching Sabre for the first time, you're trying to work out who's the one that's initiating the attack. Brilliant there from Carlan. That should have been Brune.
It really should have been. And the thing for Brune is I don't think she can really afford to give up too much space behind her, because Carlan is not running after and chasing her down and trying to find a super explosive attack at the end. She's being very patient on the long attacks, and she's scoring on every single one of them. She's not giving anything away on the long attack. Brune can't get stop cuts in there, and she's not finding a parry if she steps away. She can't find that parry. She finds the parry if she gets it early and establishes the right of way there. So Brune, if she goes on the attack, all she has to do is land it and finish it. And twice now she's had the right of way, and it's Carlan that's come away with the hit when Brune, quite frankly, should have scored already 8-3.
Yeah. So what does Brune need to do? Close the distance up, keep it in the middle a bit more?
Well, that's partly to do with what Carlan does in the middle. I would say, if I was Jean-Philippe Durel having a chat with her right now, I'd be saying, look, you can't give up a lot. You can't give her the space to develop a long attack. She's just being too strong at the moment on the long attack. So she's got to push her opponent. But when she gets the right of way and decides to go, she has to finish. She absolutely has to finish her attack. If she steps into the middle and they both go, well, then I think you're probably right. She's got more chance of getting something in the middle than going backwards. So I would be going out on the attack patiently to start with. But Carlan, the master tactician, is making all the right decisions at the moment, and she's very strong defensively. It's looking ominous, I would say, for Manon Brune.
So this next point will be crucial. After the break, will it see Brune getting back into this match? Brune goes forward, stops. Now Carlan's attacking and wins. Comes through with that long attack. Brune stopped there, didn't continue on.
She's scared to finish her attack. She's worried about the Ukrainian defence. And I don't blame her. Carlan has got a brilliant defence.
There's early a card start. Coming out.
Early start from Brune. Immediate yellow card. She does that again. It's a point to Carlan. So now her attack is threatened. That's better. That's much better. She's skipping in light-footed, small steps, and then when she sees the moment to go, she finishes. Really nice stuff from Manon Brune. She needs to string a few hits together here, though.
It's about going on a roll.
Decision made by both of them right off the line. Brune gets semi-fortunate pair of riposte in there, and again setting that Brune. One up really well. She stepped in, eyes open, looked to see what Carlan was doing, and then she exploded and finished her attack. See the little
came
step
up
forward.
Underneath brilliantly. Yeah, so talk about momentum. If Brune can get this one, she can.
She's strung those few hits together. Yeah. She's made this a little bit more of a match now. Skip, skip, skip from Brune, but she's going forward the whole time, and she lands the attack. Didn't travel much distance with the first three steps there, but she was moving forwards.
Now what will Carlan do?
Carlan's got to lure out the attack, I think. Yeah, the same thing there. Carlan's stepping forwards a little bit more strongly. Brune calls for a video. I don't think this one's going to turn around. It wasn't as obvious that it was Brune's hit. Yuri Marchenko, very calm, giving very clear and concise instructions to Carlan.
So nothing going, nothing given. Brune losing one of her video appeals.
That's what you've got to worry about. If you go out on that long step lunge attack and Carlan hasn't stepped into distance, she's going to get out of the way every time.
And just catches the blade, parries it.
technically, that's a yellow card for Carlan for stopping the fight. So as Carlan looks at the referee, it means the fight stopped. She was suggesting that Brunei started early. Now they're both on a yellow. Still the attack from the Ukrainian. Slow, patient, steady attack. Brunei just dropped the ball for a second.
Yeah,
there.
And she needs to get back to what she was doing after the break. Those few points that she managed to string together. Brunei rallied at that point, and she did that by being committed going forwards. Commit going forwards, keep going.
Now, this is now a problem for Brunei. She's not found a parry riposte, and she's not going to get one there either. Carlan
defeated Brunei's attack using distance brilliantly there, picked up the right of way. And when Carlan is going forward like that, Brunei has not been able to find the blade. That, for me, was Carlan's. So 13-8, Olga Carlan just 2 points away from winning another European title. Madame Brunei skips in lively.
Good attack. She needs to nail a couple more of these. Well, I think she can't really afford to give Carlan any more hits before she gets level. Carlan gets to 14. I think she'll see it over the line.
For me, that was Brunei's.
Yep, you're right. She steps forward, uses a little bit of foil there, in fact. Using the tip of her sword.
Yeah. So 13-10. Oh.
Brunei's picked up the right way, though. Patient. She does find the blade.
Yeah. Now, beat attack. So found the blade with the beat.
Yeah, she found the blade, and that's what's given us a no. You can understand why Carlan's asking about it, because she looks like she flicks her sword upwards as well. Referee has had a look at the video, and he said, first action, no from Carlan. Right of way established from Brunei. It's not done yet.
It isn't done yet. Carlan just needs two to get over the line. Brunei needs two to level. That's nothing given there. No way of separating who started the attack first. This point's so crucial. Oh, no. We just have...
There's a bit of fluff on the end of Brunei's weapon. That would be very distracting, to be fair to her.
So here we go. 13-11.
Oh, for me, it's blocked out, and Florea gives that as well. Can Brunei do this?
Definitely she can. She's been trailing the whole match. Now she needed to finish that. Here comes Carlan. Carlan's not failed at one of these long attacks yet.
But Brunei,
she doesn't fail there.
Brunei was good, though, that time. It was much better. She was keeping the distance closer, so she had more chance of picking up the blade, and she made Carlan really work hard for that one. But Brunei's got to keep moving forwards to stay in this.
Well, Carlan just 1 point away from claiming another European gold medal.
Together.
Referee's not going to give that. Brunei needs... Nothing given. Now the tactics now. Who will be the first to change what they're doing? Who will take the risk? Parry riposte. Carlan's got it. Parry riposte. Carlan's got it.
Superb brilliant stuff for the last hit as well.
Brilliant from Olga Carlan. Manon Brunei did well. She did well to get back into the fight. But Olga Carlan really a masterclass in tactics. And Manon Brunei, you've got to say, in the end, just didn't commit in the first half of that fight. Gave Carlan too much of a lead. And glimpses of brilliance from Brunei, but Carlan absolutely superb all the way through. And that's what it means to Olga Carlan to take another European gold medal.
Hugs all round. Vasil Milenshev, who was assisting in that congratulating Olga Karlan. And look, she can't quite believe it. It means that much to her. And I tell you why, Graham. The Ukrainian team really rely on her, and I think it's going to be a tricky ask for them to qualify as a team for the Olympic Games. They have got a chance, but it's not a dead cert. So these points at this European Championships are crucial to her in being able to qualify as an individual for Tokyo 2020 if the Ukrainian team don't make it.
And 15-12 in the end, Olga Karlan is yet again a European champion.